It's now a year until the Summer Olympics get underway in Tokyo. Second time lucky, we hope they were, of course, due to be held this year, starting tomorrow, in fact, until the coronavirus so pointedly interrupted. But will Japan and the rest of the world be ready for sport's biggest show? Olympic gold medalist, world champ, Helberg Supreme Award winner, three times America's Cup grinder, and the New Zealand team's chef de mission. Rob Waddell joins us now, beams in now. Morena, Rob, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. Yeah, no, thanks for letting me join by Zone.
We're delighted to have you with us. Boy, oh boy, this is an unknowable, really, isn't it? Do you think we will be at the Olympics in Japan a year from now?
Yeah, well, obviously there's really high uncertainty, and that's hard for all of our team. It's hard for all of our athletes. We're very much planning for it going ahead, and I guess the big landmark this in recent times has been that we've been able to reschedule all the venues and we've been able to reschedule the dates. So we're working on it and we're doing our best to make it happen.
Rob, you know, as a former Olympian and as a gold medal winner, that this is an extraordinary cycle, and you peak towards 4 years and you work towards it and you set everything around that time frame. Suddenly it's a 5-year time frame. How hard is it to kind of stop and start again?
Yeah, well, that's probably one of the hardest things for the athletes. And one thing we've tried to do during this period is really engage with the athletes and understand what we can do to help, how they're feeling. And I think that uncertainty you highlight, John, is just the biggest thing. So, you know, it's something they're all experiencing, but there's a really wide range of emotions out there. You know, for some athletes, this is the most difficult thing. You know, they've got to put their life on hold. They don't know, you know, what's happening and what's around the corner. But for others, this has given them some reprieve. It's given them some extra time. They've been able to recover from injury. It might have helped their qualification. Mm. So there's a really wide range of emotions going through the team at the moment.
Athletes, of course, Olympians, of course, are super competitive people, and there isn't the competition. So normally we would be off at diamond meets or somewhere in the States or doing whatever's required to compete. That's not happening. So how are people coping in the absence of that?
Yeah, and I think every sport's different. It's we're here in New Zealand, and I think probably during the lockdown, I was concerned for some of the athletes that I was worried actually couldn't train. You know, you weren't allowed to go to the facilities that you needed to use. But now our athletes are able to get back into that, and it's really cool to see some of the adaptation that's happening. I know, for example, our sailors have been replicating and trying to get some sort of similar environment to what they might have had in Inoshima. Others have chosen to, you know, have a break at the moment. There's just different things going on within the sports. But, you know, it's quite a different environment today to what we would have been normally expecting and experiencing. I just had an alarm pop up on my phone before saying your opening ceremony tomorrow. So, you know, at this time we'd be normally in a much warmer environment, and we'd be, you know, welcoming teams into the village. We'd be getting our athletes ready, and we'd be having our team ceremony tonight, which is a pretty, you know, pretty big deal for us, and announcing our flag bearer. So it's quite a contrast.
Did that really just pop up on your phone? Opening ceremony tomorrow.
Yeah, that's right.
Nice.
Yeah, and often, you know, in the last week, I've had, you know, you look at your calendar for various things going on. You go, oh, hang on, I can't make that because I've got a team function, or no, I've got the opening ceremony, or whatever it might be. So, yeah, even those things are reminding you, giving you some nostalgia.
Have you had people calling you and saying, Rob, I'm not sure. I'm not sure I can reboot. I'm not sure I can do this. I need your help, Chief.
I think the tricky thing is, you know, no matter what athletes you talk to, and we've tried to engage really widely. And to be fair, I think, John, we're probably as engaged with our athletes as we've ever been at this time, because we've had to be through this virtual world we've all been connected in. There's still that uncertainty there, and all we can be is at the front of the queue to find out as much as we possibly can to make sure that our athletes are really well informed. You know, the obvious question I get asked is, Rob, is it going to happen? You know, as if I've got a secret magic wand and I'm holding the answer close to my chest. I think the key thing is we're going through a process. The games have been rescheduled, the venues are confirmed, and around sort of October, November, we expect to have some pretty good indications of how we can host, how we can hold a games. They're calling them countermeasures, and they're things you might expect, such as, you know, what would be the social distancing, will there be spectators, when would athletes come into the village, you know, and just working through all those logistical details. So we'll have a much better idea by the end of the year of how it's looking.
And they're the big things, aren't they? For example, you know, we're seeing a lot of sports take place overseas without crowds, and so it would be lovely to have clarity around that as early as the end of this year.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're, you know, we're working hard to try and understand that and make sure that we're learning as much as we can. But I think also, especially for our athletes that are, you know, qualifying and still got to qualify next year, we've got 189 spots have qualified for our Olympic team, and we'd expect another, you know, 20 or 30. We think it'll be our biggest Olympic team ever. So there's still some understanding work to be done for the athletes around what, you know, those that still have to qualify, what that looks like next year. And that's part of what we're working on with them at the moment and trying to help them and make sure they're best prepared.
Rob Waddell, chef de mission, who would have been at the opening ceremony tomorrow. As he just said, we wish you and all the team really well in making something really difficult work, and that is a four-year cycle become a five-year cycle. Thank you for joining us, Rob. It's always lovely to talk to you. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me. Thank you.